Hello all, my name is Krishnag and welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this particular video, we'll be discussing about ridge and lasso regression. These are some kind of regularization hypertuning techniques and I'll try to explain you in this particular video completely. We'll just go in depth understanding all the techniques and why exactly it is used. In my previous video, I have already uploaded a tutorial regarding linear regression, guys. Please make sure that you know how linear regression is implemented in order to follow this particular video. You also need to know some information regarding bias and variance. I've already uploaded many videos regarding bias and variance, and also in my previous tutorial of this specific playlist, I've also uploaded linear regression. I've explained the maths behind it. Now let us go and understand how exactly ridge and lasso regression works. And make sure, guys, you watch this video till the end because I'm going to explain various things. I'm going to cover both the topic in this same video because there is some minor difference between ridge and lasso regression. Now, let me just give a small overview about linear regression, guys. As we know that linear regression, suppose this is my parameter like experience. Okay, based on the experience, this is my salary. Suppose these are my two parameters. I need to predict based on the experience what will be my salary. And this is nothing but number of years of experience. I have some of the points which is something like this, you know. And what I do is that I try to create a best fit line with the help of linear regression. Now this is properly fine. We get the best fit line. Whenever we have this kind of data, sometimes we get it. Now, when do we use ridge and lasso regression? We need to find out. Okay, we need to understand. Let me just give you a very small example, guys. Suppose I consider that, okay, I'm training a model wherein based on the years of experience, I need to predict salary. And just understand that my training data has only 2 points, which is like this. Okay, now when I am actually creating the best fit line with the help of linear regression, I usually create this best fit line which passes through this particular point. Now when this line passes through these 2 points, the next thing is that we try to calculate the sum of residuals. I'll also say this as my cost function because I need to reduce this cost function, right? So this is my cost function over here. Right now you can see that I can basically define this cost function like summation of I is equal to 1 to n y minus y hat. Okay, now what is y? Y is usually given by the equation y is mx plus c, right? Sorry, this is y hat. Okay, and y is basically my value with respect to these years of experience, what is the salary. Okay, and this y hat is basically my best fit line. Now in this case, when I do y minus y hat, it will always be zero because it is passing perfectly to both through this particular point, right? It is passing through these points. So we have sum of residuals as zero. Now understand, guys, this is for my training data set. This is for my training data set, right? Now imagine, and always remember, whenever we want to create any model, let it be a classification model or regression model, we need to create a generalized model. Okay, that basically means that now suppose for my test data, I have some of the points over here. Suppose this is my test data. Okay, now what will happen? Now I have got, with the help of this particular training data set, I've got this as my best fit line. Okay, now if I go and measure these points, I go and find out y minus y hat whole square. You can see that there's a huge difference, right? So this leads to a case of something called as overfitting. Overfitting, that basically means for my training data set, my model has given me a wonderful result that is completely low bias result, you know, low bias, a less error result, you can say. But when I go and test for test data set, now you can see my test data set is over here, right? My new point is over here and it is predicting somewhere here, right? Now when I do that, there is a huge difference, and if I do the summation of this, it leads to something called as overfitting. Now what does overfitting mean? Overfitting basically says that with respect to the training data set, you're getting low error, but with the help of test data set, or for the test data set, you're getting a high error, right? So that is the basic difference between overfitting. In case of underfitting, what will happen? For the training data set also, you're getting high error. For the test data set also, you're getting high error. Okay, that is what is underfitting. Now, I hope I made you understand. Let me just draw this particular point once again so that you'll be able to understand. Okay, now let me make you understand once again. Suppose this is my data set. Okay, this is my training data set. I've created a best fit line, right? But suppose my new points or new test data is here, here, here. Okay, at that particular point, if I'm using this as a best fit line to predict this, this will be my point, right? This should be my point for which I'm predicting. Right, and if I go and see this particular difference, this is huge, right? So this is basically leading to an overfitting condition. Now we can use ridge and lasso regression so that we make this overfitting condition, which is basically high variance, we can convert this high variance into low variance. Now we'll try to understand. Always remember, guys, a generalized model or a good model should always have low bias and low variance. Okay, so that is as much as low for both low bias and low variance, it should have this kind of properties. Then, but that particular model is basically called as a generalized model. So let us go and understand how ridge and lasso regression solves this particular problem. Okay, so we'll try to understand that. So I'm going to rub this some of the things so that you'll be able to make you understand in short. Okay, and always remember, guys, in linear regression, the cost function is this, right? And we always try to reduce this cost function. Okay, so in this particular case, my cost function was coming as zero, right? Because I had no difference in my training data set between the best fit line and the data points. But in the case of test data set, I had huge error. So that leads to an overfitting condition. Now let us go and understand how does ridge regression actually work. Okay, we'll just try to understand that. So guys, let us go and understand how does ridge regression first of all work. Okay, now this is my model that I've actually created, you know. So here is my experience, here is my salary. Okay, now based on experience, I'm going to predict the salary. This is the best fit line, right? Usually the sum of residuals or square of residuals, or even I can say cost function, is usually given by summation of I is equal to 1 to n y minus y hat whole square, right? And you know that in linear regression we try to reduce this error, but in ridge regression what we do is that we add one more parameter. So this whole square difference plus lambda multiplied by slope whole square. Now we will try to reduce this whole operation in case of ridge regression. I'll make you understand what exactly this is. Okay, so y minus y hat whole square, which is my cost function, I can say, or sum of residuals, I can say, right, plus lambda multiplied by slope whole square. Now remember, guys, remember one thing in this. Okay, here my slope is quite steep, you know, it is quite steep, it is quite in the upper direction, you know, like steep. When I say that, usually what does steep mean? Okay, we'll try to understand. Within, suppose this is my one unit of increase in experience, suppose this is my 2, this is my 3 years. Now what does steep mean? Steep basically says that in a unit movement towards the x-axis from 2 to 3, if I go and see the slope, there is a huge movement in the slope. Okay, so this is one of the movements. Suppose this may be 2 units movement, right? So this scenario is something called a steep slope. Okay, so understand, here in this particular case, if we have a steep slope, always remember that it will lead to an overfitting case. Why? I'll tell you just now. Okay, I'll just try to explain this. Okay, now you can see that with the unit increase in the years of experience, there is a high increase in salary. Okay, so now what will happen in this particular case? In this particular case, I know this value will be zero because it is already passing through all the points, right? So this best fit line passes through all the points. But now we'll try to add this. Okay, add this with this value. And remember, in this particular case, we have slope as high, you know. And remember, guys, this is an overfitting case right now. Overfitting, and we need to reduce this overfitting with the help of ridge regression. That is what we are trying to do over here. Okay, so understand that this particular value is zero plus. Okay, now lambda, consider that this is this lambda value. I'll try to assign one value as 1. I'll tell you what all values we can assign lambda as, but usually from 0 to any positive number, that particular value can be assigned to lambda. But I'll tell you what is the main importance of this particular lambda. Okay, so suppose this is my 1 multiplied by slope whole square. Now suppose, guys, in this particular case, my slope is steep. Just understand, I'm just giving you a technique called as it is very, very steep. Okay, so let me just give an example. Okay, this is 1.3. So when I do 1.3 whole square, I'm just taking as an example, that will make you understand very clearly. I'm just taking one example saying that the slope is 1.3. Now in this particular case, if I do the calculation, it will be nothing but 0 plus 169, which is nothing but 1.69. Okay. Now remember, guys, this is my sum of residual, this whole value, and I need to reduce this value. Currently it is 1.69. Okay. 1.69. Now in my linear regression, this cost function, when it was zero, I used to stop there. But now I'm not stopping over here. I have got 1.69. Now I'll go and try to see for other line which will reduce this value. So for that, suppose I take another line which looks like something like this. Okay, this is my second line, guys. Understand, this is my second line, second best fit line. Now in this particular case, this y minus y hat, definitely it will be a smaller number. Okay, this difference, this is my y hat, this is my y, this is my y, this is my y hat. Now this difference will be smaller. Suppose some small value will be here over here. Okay, again, I'm not telling you what small value. Plus lambda, I know I have initialized to 1, multiplied by, now the slope, understand, now the slope will be a smaller value, because now understand, the steepness has gone down, right? Now when the steepness has gone down, this basically indicates that with the unit increase in your x-axis, there is a small increase in the y-axis, right? Now when this value reduces, this will be a smaller number again, right? Initially it was 1.3, right? Now let me just take it as 1, right? It is just 1. So this small value plus 1, it will be less than this value. It will be less than this value, like 1.39, right? So this will definitely be less. Now it knows that, okay, you, instead of using this best fit line, I can use this particular line. And guys, I've just given an example of calculation. Always remember, this value will be less than this, okay, because of the slope. The slope is reducing. Now when we know that this is less than this, I will select this as my best fit line. Now this as my best fit line. Now I'll consider this as my best fit line, since my this particular error is less, and our task is that we need to reduce this value, right? Now what we are trying to do over here, we are penalizing where we have higher slopes. We are penalizing features which has higher slopes. What does this mean? Suppose this is my equation, y is equal to mx plus c. Okay, m is my slope. Now if this slope value is huge, we try to penalize with the help of ridge regression by using this small formula. How we are penalizing? We are using this lambda along with the cost function. We are using these values, and every time you will be seeing that our values are actually increasing. That basically means my best fit line, I'm trying to penalize and make it less steeper, right? So if there is just one feature, this will basically be my m square, right? If suppose there are two features like this, m1 x1 plus m2 x2 plus c1. Now you have two slopes. Now in this particular case, my formula will only become lambda multiplied by m1 square plus m2 square. And similarly, any number of features will be going on, this value will just get added, square of that slope will get added. So that is what I'm actually doing it over here. And always remember, guys, why we are doing this? We are just penalizing the steeper slopes. Okay. And after some time, you'll be seeing that which will be the best fit line. And again, to find out the best fit line, whoever will be having this lesser value, that line will be selected. And again, that will just not get selected in the first iteration. Right, it has to do a lot of experiments, like how we did it for the gradient descent, right? And based on that, that particular line will get selected. And now we are trying to reduce this overfitting by this particular technique. How we are reducing? Suppose this is my best fit line that I got selected. Now remember the previous example, suppose my new points are here. Now you can see that if I go and see the difference between this best fit line and this best fit line, obviously this difference is less, right, with respect to this best fit line. Now, in short, we are reduced that particular overfitting criteria now. Now, this will lead to some, less variance, in short. Right? So that is how we are reducing this overfitting condition. There will be little bit more bias for the training data set, right? For this particular data, there will be more bias when compared to the first line that I've actually created. High bias basically means that for the training data set, we have some amount of error. Okay, greater than this particular best fit line. But for the test data set, it is giving us a generalized model by using this ridge regression. Here we are just penalizing the extra, the steeper slope, in short. The slope which is having the higher value, we are penalizing by using this particular operation. That is lambda multiplied by slope square. And we are trying to reduce this, right? As soon as this particular line will get changed like this, right? So at that time, you will be able to see that this value will get reduced more. That basically means that with the unit increase in x, definitely there will be a less, less change in the slope of this particular line, or less value change with respect to the y-axis. And that is how this criteria is actually fulfilled. Now, by this, we are definitely reducing our overfitting condition. Just try to understand in this particular way, guys. I know it looks a little bit complicated, but our main aim is just to reduce the overfitting. How we are doing reducing the overfitting? This is my sum of residual square, right? During linear regression, I have to just minimize this function. But in case of ridge regression, we have to add lambda multiplied by slope square. And lambda value will always be greater than zero to any positive value. Okay, usually we consider this as a smaller number. As we go higher, as this lambda values goes higher, this line that you see will be going very, very close towards zero. Finally, you'll be able to see the straight line. This will not be exactly zero because we are doing the squaring over here, but it will be very, very close to zero. What will be very, very close to zero? The slopes will be very, very close to zero. That you need to understand. Right? Because remember, for a straight line, it will not be exactly zero, guys. It will be very, very close to zero. And this is what is the generic formula of ridge regression. You know, the main aim of ridge regression is reducing overfitting. Right? Now we need to understand what is Lasso regression. Now for Lasso regression, I'll just make a small equation change in this. Instead of writing slope square, this will be magnitude of slope. Magnitude of slope. Now, why this is basically used? Lasso regression just not only helps in fitting or in overcoming this overfitting scenario, but also it helps us to do feature selection. Now, how does it make helps us to do feature selection? Suppose I have multiple features like M3x3, M4x4, and this is my C1. Right? Suppose this is my whole equation. Okay, and again, Lasso regression is the cost function looks something like this. Instead of slope square, we have magnitude of slope, right? Now, what does it do? This magnitude of slope is nothing but, if I write it over here, it is nothing but lambda multiplied by M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4. This is what is magnitude, you know? Now, why this magnitude is important? This magnitude, right? I told you that whenever I'm applying this slope square, right? In case of ridge regression, this was finally getting somewhere near to zero, right? This whole slope was not just a straight line. It was moving towards zero. I'll not say exactly zero, but in this case, it will move towards zero. Okay. So wherever the slope value is very, very less, those features will be removed. Okay, those features will be removed. That basically means these features are not important for predicting our best fit line. So in turn also helps us to do the feature selection. So finally, we'll just be using the most important feature like X1 and X2. All the additional features will just get removed like that. How it is done? Understand, guys, that when I'm using this magnitude, right? So this steeper line, this slope that is actually getting created will be moving towards zero, and at one time it will just go and reach zero. Okay, when it is moving towards zero, some of the feature slope value will get reduced to zero, and that is how it is basically done. Right? I know you may be having confusion between this magnitude and slope square, but just understand, I can again write a lot of equation and prove it that to you. In short, what will happen is that if I using magnitude of slope, this sum of the slopes will get zero after some time. You know, as we are going to select the best fit line, for the other features, the slopes will become zero. But in case of ridge regression, all the slopes will not get zero. It will shrink. It will shrink, but it will never reach zero. Okay. So that is proved mathematically And this is the basic difference ridge and lasso regression. In my upcoming videos, I'll also be explaining about how it can be performed with the help of a scale-on libraries. Okay, so yes, this was all about this particular video. I know this particular topic looks complicated, but just try to read some blogs and articles after understanding this particular explanation. So this was all about this particular video. I hope you understood most of the video in this particular stuff. So I'll see you all in the next video. Have a great day. Thank you one and all.